No, this is definitely something new I'm trying here. And, you know, we're going to discuss topics while I try to bring up a more, I guess, subconscious feeling as I, you know, as I draw and paint. So today we're going to be talking about, you know, layers and how do you reflect on yourself and kind of breaking down some of those barriers. So, you know what, as I talk, we're going to try to expound on this. So this is going to be kind of cool. First time doing this. So, you know, a lot of times when we're talking about how do you break down layers in yourself, you know, you tend to have that perfect layer. And of course, this isn't going to be perfect, but you tend to have this being, right? You tend to have this person. And, you know, it's, you know, I'm pretty abstract with the movement. So please, this is not realism. I'm not Michelangelo. But look, you have you tend to have the person that you are. And, you know, you feel, you see what you see when you're in the mirror or wherever you are. You kind of, you know, you become attached to this person. And when we make our decisions sometimes, we try to be black and white as a paper, black and white. So, you know, we try to, we become absolute. We stick by what we stick to. And we don't really, it's black and white. You know, you don't really know who you are. And, well, you know, you think you know who you are. That's what I'm saying. You think you know who you are. And, you know, through experiences and what you see, you begin to add small flavors to yourself. You begin to add small flavors to yourself. You know, and the way I'm gonna do this is we're gonna try to have a light coming down. So you add small flavors to yourself. You see the blues. You think you're calm. You know, a lot of people, when they use blue, I love the color blue, but when I think of blue, I think of calmness. And sometimes we try to represent ourselves as being calm, so on and so forth. Now, but the thing is, as you go through life, you tend to ignore certain traits you may have. And here comes the red, because, you know, deep down you may have some reds. You know, you may have some characteristics that you don't like about yourself, but you can hide them, or you can be in a state where of delusion maybe, or whatever it may be, and you don't think that what you just become blind to who you really are. This is interesting because this is my first time doing this, and it's just like, it's funny how you gotta, you know, I tend to be quiet and I just focus in and create work. So, and I'm coming out, this is like my first time doing this in a while, so bear with me. So, like I said, you have the image of yourself. It's dark, it's black and white. And then as you try to develop, and as you develop, you start to see certain tendencies. Like, you start to believe in yourself that you're blue. You have these blue tendencies. You have these, you're calm, you're smart, you're patient, you are a hard worker. You know, it could be all these things. And then, you know, as through life comes, you never know what life brings you, but sometimes it's just not that. You know, it's not always gonna be that. And as you see, you begin to build up different colors in yourself. You start to build up different identities, different values that may or may not be you. So that's something you always gotta be conscious of. Your surroundings play a big role in who you are and what you become. Now, you know, a lot of people think, you know, they're subject to their realities, or you know, what they see is what they get, and they can't control it. So here we are, you know, kind of that light blue hue. That's what people see themselves or see their reality at times, and it's kind of, it kind of comes with that whole thing. You're not looking at yourself. And when you look at yourself, you start to see these small ribbons, you know. Sometimes when you try to buy a steak, you can see the marbling. And then in life, you know, there's marbling. And it could be vice versa in a sense, where you think the red, you know, is what the good is or the bad is, you know. My life is what it is, blah, 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 blah. And as you look closer, you start to see the marbling, and you start to see those streaks of like, okay, maybe life isn't bad. Maybe life, you know, can be worked on. Or vice versa. I keep kind of messing up because man, this is kind of complicated, but, or it could be vice versa, where you think your whole life is just full of pain, you know, or whatever it may be, and as you look closer to the marble, and you see small little flashes, you see small little flashes of work and life. So, wow, this is crazy. And I don't want this to be super long just because, you know, people's attention span doesn't go that long, so, of course. And so here it is. You have this body. Working with me here. So you have this body here, which you believe yourself to be, what you are. You kind of got your environment. Now, I'm going to use this yellow because it's kind of one of those things that, maybe not yellow. Let's not use yellow. I don't want to use white because I own white. I'm going to use, we're going to use yellow. We're going to use yellow, for example. And somehow, and you have to see, you're attached to this. You may, as I draw this, I may be attached to this piece like, wow, this is something crazy. It's abstract. It's beautiful. Now, you have to step outside yourself. I use the yellow because it's transparent. You can still see a form, but, you know, it's transparent. You can draw over the type, you can draw over something and still kind of see it, but you can see that fade there, okay? So, you know, this is you stepping outside of yourself and we're looking at what you see. Look at yourself. You know, I love to do it's my new thing with the facial expressions and trying to get that look, and it's just so cool to me. You know, you can kind of really whittle around in there, really get something interesting, like this interesting bone structure. It's just cool. Like, you see the structure there? It's kind of hard, you know, because these are kind of fast, but you see the structure there. You see I can put the shoulders in there. You see a small essence of yourself, and you see who you are here. Now, as you look at yourself, you still may be in awe of yourself. You still may be like, oh, look at these strokes, look at all this. But it's not that there's failures and there's wrongs in your image. It's just you have to look at certain things unbiasedly. That's why we have to step outside of ourselves. Now, step away from yourself. Step away from who you think you may be. You may be this top level exec. You may be this person that has a huge social life. You may be attached to a location, a certain habit, and you step away from yourself and you see what you see what you look like. And to get to this state, sometimes it may take meditation, sometimes it may take a real big fall, wake-up call, for you to realize what's really going on and really see who you are. And you know, from there, I keep doing this little chest thing. Oh my goodness, it's been so long. But once you kind of look and see what's really going on, and then when you get to this state, like I said, it takes meditation, it takes falling. And when you get to this point, you have to reevaluate your values, what you believe in, what makes sense. Are these patterns on the body that you became attached to, how can you turn these into positive improvements? How can you turn this into something positive? You can grow from this, okay? So now, since you basically, this whole time, been, you know, attached to this body, and it's like, you know, dang, like, coming out of it, you're like, whoa, I was attached to this body, man. I can see this, you know, you can see the pain, you can see the improvements, you can see, you know, how you've grown as a person. Now, of course, we're all not perfect, so that's what I'm saying. You look at these strokes, and you have to analyze, was this stroke necessary? Did I make improvements here? Could I have done something different here? You don't do it as in the point where you're like, you're upset at yourself, you're angry. You don't do that. You do it constructively. And then sometimes you gotta go through a whole different process. And then that's when you get you take things and you go different with it. You come through and you change the whole being. And then you may not be able to see it, but there's a whole nother face on here. You know, you see the structure, you see the eye, you see the hair. This is crazy, right? Bear with me here, people, bear with me. Now, you messed up, you put a whole nother image on your thing, you panicking, like, this is not, you want to go back to who you were, but no, we don't do that. Life is about constantly growing, constantly being uncomfortable. Once you find a position where you love to be uncomfortable, or you're comfortable with being uncomfortable, now you take this new image of yours, and you go through and you change, you know, you go through and you make your marks. and you stay patient, because you know, when we live in a world where everything's instant gratification, everything is about being somewhere now. And as you grow, look at that, as you grow, you get the lips, you get the eyes. As you grow, you see something bigger. You see something, like the whole, your image can't even fit in the box that you were originally in. You put yourself in a box when you were attached to that figure. Now, as you came back and you flipped the whole script, you a whole different person. This person ain't even, you can't even recognize that. Or you see it and you see how it's incorporated with you. Like you look at your past self and you look at your future self and you see how they both connect to each other and they communicate with each other. So when you rip those layers away, you gotta step away and don't be the person that's like, I'm perfect, I'm the greatest thing to ever walk this earth, I cannot do no wrong, I'm always learning, woe is me, no one understands me, blah, 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 blah. You know how people are. Especially the quote-unquote, everybody got that quote-unquote woke friend that thinks they are just this ultimate being and they can always, you know, they always trying to tell you something, try to give you a book to read, whatever it may be. It's just, you know, you gotta step away from yourself. No one's perfect in this world. No one's perfect in this world. You know, I might bring some reds in this one. You know, like I said, when you paint sometimes, you go into this weird state where you're just like, you can't even think for real. So honestly, I don't even know what I was saying half the time doing this video. Like, I don't even know what I was saying. So, you know, I hope I'm gonna look back, you know, it's gonna make sense. You know, enjoy the art if you are an art person. You know, enjoy the words if you use to knowledge and self-discovery. But yeah, and as you go here, you see the nose, you see the eyes, you work with what you got. And that's part of painting, that's part of art. Like, no one's gonna understand your art for the most part, you know? No one's gonna understand your art, no one's gonna understand who you really, what you're doing, you know? But it doesn't matter. And sometimes you can freak out because you want to compare yourself to other people. Like, you want to compare yourself to Michelangelo, or you want to compare yourself to Leonardo, or, you know, somebody in your class. And it's like, art is like this subconscious feeling. If everybody drew the same, what's the point of having art? Because art is like this, it's different, it's, you know? It opens people's eyes, it shows you something you've never seen before, or it resonates with you, or it puts things into words that you have never seen. Or you were thinking about, and it's like you see something, you're like, whoa, or gives you a feeling. Art is just this universal language. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't have to. There is no legend. There is no dictionary on art. People try to put art in this box, and it's like they're usually not even artists themselves, and they're just, you know, they're doing whatever. And people try to, you know, they try to make art bigger than what it is or smaller than what it is. And it's like, it's just, it's in this weird middle. It's in the gray. There's many values, there's many hues. Nothing is absolute in art. And nothing is absolute in life. So as you go through life, realize, you know, what you are and what you're doing. And right now I'm always about the vision. My wave is about the vision. You know, I've always been about colors and all about that and wild strokes, but lately, I negate the eyes, because we focusing on the mind, the vision, you know? We focusing on that, what you feel in your heart, what you feel in yourself, your intuition. So, that being said, that is my TED Talk today, man. That's my art TED Talk for the day. I love this, look. I love this. I'll see y'all later. Peace.